mangalani bhavantu.
I know bodies out in the funeral home over there. Not talking, not waking up, not looking at you or smiling. So Lavanya, we'll miss you. We hopelessly sit here thinking about you. We remember the time we spent with you. We recall the funny episodes and events. We recall the serious ones as well. Pardon me. I recall our first meeting when your professor introduced me to you, and thereafter I was in your life. And in fact, I want to say you were in my life. I would bug you and bother you every week so I know what's going on in your life. And if I don't see you for 2 or 3 weeks, I would come upstairs and bother you again. I watched you grow for the past 1 year. I watched you succeed. I watched you being at highs and lows. Sometimes she would tell me some sad stories at school or in life or just missing home. But most of the time I hear happy stories.
So it's a totally dedicated person. I mean, I've never seen another grad student so much into fieldwork and never said no to any work that we would assign, any research work. She used to go to the field around 5:36 in the morning and take care of her research, and always planning ahead, pushing me into ordering materials that she needed. And she also published pretty good. She, you know, as an MS student, it's not very much that they author full publications, but she co-authored several. They were all published in very, very reputed journals. Not easy to publish in those. So the thing is that she had such a caliber and capabilities. Very promising student, and she took her work very seriously. Quite pleasant personality, and any response that I would give to her, she would just own it.
It's been 8 months I'm here, and first of all, I'm very sorry for the Aburi's family for their loss. And when I was here in the U.S., she was the one who gave me right for first 2 months, like in August and September. She always used to, you know, wake me up at 5:30, though she has to go to her farm at 5:30. So she used to wake me around 5 o'clock. She used to say that I'll be at home by 5:30. You'll be better ready by 5:30 because I don't want to get late to my farm. She was so dedicated to her work that
sometimes she woke up early morning, 3 o'clock, to go to farm.